And now, through the, as I always say, the magic of television, Ciarán Hinds has flown back to Ireland, and we're here with the director, Stephen Brown of The Sea. Wow, you're a happy guy.
I am very happy. I'm very happy. It's great to be at Toronto.
We're at the Toronto International Film. What an honor to be chosen.
Great honor. And great honor to sort of step up to the plate with a movie. I'm delighted. I could have perhaps chosen an easier one with car chases, but I chose John Bevel's great
novel. I don't even drive. I hate cars. Exactly. I hate car chases.
Exactly. Let's leave the cars at home and let's focus a bit more on what the internal workings of our characters are up to.
Right, right. And I'm Irish, and the film is set in Ireland, so it resonated tremendously for me. And what part of Ireland is that?
It was shot in the sunny southeast of Ireland, County Wexford. The beaches where we shot, actually, were the same beaches that Spielberg shot Saving Private Ryan. Little known fact. Well, and so all the locals thought that you know there was going to be a bonanza and another big film was going to roll in, and it was us. I mean, I drank enough Guinness, I think, to sort of keep a couple of the pubs going.
Since you brought it up, the Guinness there does not taste like the Guinness here.
You need to go to Ireland to get a good pint of Guinness, to pull a good pint.
And I mean, you don't need to go. You're spoiled forever.
Yeah, I mean, Dublin, you get a pretty good pint.
Okay.
You need it. We post-produced it in Dublin. The whole thing was an Irish production.
Okay.
We shot it and post-produced it in Ireland with the help of a great Irish co-producer, David Collins, who helped us set up the whole thing on that side. Luke Rogan, Michael Robinson in London. So it was sort of 50-50 split, really. To be honest, we're an Anglo-Irish co-production.
Okay. So how did you find out that you got accepted? Where were you when you got the acceptance for the Toronto entrance? And is this the world premiere?
This is the North American premiere. We premiered the film in the UK at a small festival, but perfectly formed, in Edinburgh a few weeks ago, the Edinburgh Film Festival.
Yes, of course.
Yep.
Right.
And then it went to Galway, and this is its first North American outing. And this really is where the market lies.
It's a
tough one.
There's a lot of people here.
Our sleeves are rolled up, and I think the point is not to shout too loud, is to try and meet the right people, make the right connections, connect with the market in the right way that's suitable for a film like this.
But with 350 other films here, is that difficult?
Ask my sales team. I do have a sales team, so you know.
I'm not here on my own.
Yeah, you know. So no, I mean, I think we did our homework and we've set things up in the right way. And yes, 350 other movies, but you know, a film can still stand out in its own way if you make the right connections. I found a lot of warmth and generosity here from my perspective, and I think my sales team are getting some good feedback as well. So let's see where it takes us.
And a very well-known cast with, of course, Mr. Hinds and Charlotte Rampling looking so fabulous at age. How old is she now?
Oh, I'd have to kill you if I told you that. I'm sorry. How could I tell you that?
We'll just have to guess that she's, you know,
she's
older than we think.
As fresh as ever and as very sharp as ever. Now, here's the thing. She's an interesting character. People are approachable. The good thing about film is that it's not up itself. It'll let you approach. Here's me, Mr. Nobody, comes along. I've read this great novel. It's my first feature. I'm under no illusions here. I've made a couple of short films, interesting shorts, but you know, I've come up through the industry the long way.
Which is what? Television?
Assistant directing, then TV, then business TV, music video, you name it, I've been there.
Okay.
I've made the tea, you know.
That's a lot of experience.
I do have a lot of experience, but then when I read this novel, it resonated for me very personally, and this became the film I had to make at this time where I am. And you know what? If you go with that conviction and that passion to make a movie like this, producers will come back and say, okay, let's see, let's try and get this thing cast. We cast it with a magnificent cast, as you've kindly said, you know.
They're all kind of well known here.
But by the way, we have three fantastic children in the film as well, who stepped up to the plate and interacted beautifully. So it's about trust. It's about saying, well, look, if we got this far, let's take it into the arena. Let's do it. Let's make it. And I'm very thrilled with the result.
So where were you when you got the phone call?
For Toronto.
It's like winning the Oscar, getting here. I have to say it.
It is rather. I think I just got a call from one of my producer Luke's team saying, here's the good news for the day. You've got to Toronto. My wife immediately started sort of selecting dresses. I had to come here on my own, I'm afraid. She hates me. But, she'll come next time.
All right. Well, it's a dazzlingly beautiful day in early September. Here we are at the Toronto Film Festival. I mean, it's an experience like no other. I mean, have you ever been to Cannes?
I have been to Cannes. Cannes is such an unforgiving, but beautiful. I mean, it's beautiful. It's glamorous.
It's a zoo.
This is less of a zoo. There is some genuine kindness, interest, empathy amid all of the razzmatazz here. And I think that perhaps it being placed where it is in Canada, both outside Hollywood and outside Europe and Asia, but where these people love to come and respect, it's got a slightly more sort of sensible feel to it.
Well, the thing that joins everyone here in common is their love of film. There are so many film theaters in this city, and the audiences are just—they can't buy enough. To everything is sold out completely. Did you know that?
It's insane. Insane in a good way. You know, thank God there are still people that like to come and sit in a dark room and watch film as it should be watched, and the way that the films are shown is fantastic. And that's very heartening. You know, our screenings have been sold out as much as the big films have been sold.
So I know.
So, you know, that alone gives one hope.
Well, there's an educational system here in place in Canada that is superior to the United States. And I can say that because it's true. And there is a feeling among the people here, especially, and the entire nation of Canada, this is the one big thing they do every year that they are so proud of that they have to be there, like be there or be square.
I haven't seen any Mounties coming in, though. I mean, where are the Mounties?
Well, they're also well-behaved here.
Oh, they are very well-behaved.
They stand in queues.
I know. They're a bit like the Brits like that, you know.
The longer you stay here, the more British this place will get.
Yeah, and I mean, the Queen is still on the currency here. So, you know, we do have to behave ourselves
when
we pay for
every wall you look at. I know. Royal York.
Come on.
I'm surprised they don't make everyone stand up and sing "God Save the Queen."
I'll do it if you like.
Well, no, I being a queen, I would too. But I always felt they were just singing about me. But that was always so moving when I lived in England for a long time. Obviously, my father's British from Liverpool, and
great city, fantastic city,
city of comedians. Yuck. but Toronto has its own thing going on, but I also see it in the city of Montreal, where they also love film and are passionate about it. It's like the whole country has not, and I think America has fallen away from the film-going habit. The box offices are down all over the place. Mm-hmm. People like to stay home and watch it in their special, you know, situations in their living rooms, you know, their big screens or whatever.
Fair enough. I'm not gonna complain there either. Maybe the sea will eventually filter into a few living rooms too. But the best way to watch any movie is a communal activity, and then you go into the world of the film that's up there in the screen in front of you, and there's nothing like it.
Stephen, do you have people having problems misspelling your first name as I do?
Oh yeah, all the time.
It's so irritating.
Stephen, it's nice to meet another PH.
Yes, a PH or a V. They're constantly.
Oh, go away with your V's. Yeah, keep your lousy V's. Very common a V, Stephen. Whenever I meet a Stephen with a V, I kind of.
This is very racist, but my mother used to say Stephen is the Catholic spelling. It was the first martyr.
But I'm the Jewish spelling.
Oh my God!
Well, no, we could have a problem here.
All right, okay. Well, it's nice to meet a Jewish Stephen.
Yeah.
There is one.
Yeah, no, my dad phoned my mum up when I was born. He said, we're calling him Stephen.
With a PH.
So what do you want?
The first thing I have to say with to people a PH. When they're looking up my YouTube channel, which you'll see right there, youtube.com/Stephen Holt Show, which is what you're on right now.
I'm going to watch it.
And then say PH, Stephen with a PH thing. Oh, you know, it's like some kind of archaic thing from back in.
Perfect. It's beautiful.
What, did you always want to be a director?
Yes.
You did?
Yes. Hmm. But I just came up the long way, you know. But I did always want to be a director. I saw 2001. My dad took me to see a 70 mil screening of 2001 when I was 13. I'm 100 years old, okay. No, so, okay, all right. Well, we can all argue about that as well. Old Stevens show. welcome to the old Stevens show. And, yeah. That was my. I don't think I'm ever going to make a huge movie like that. Who knows? Maybe I will. But it certainly awoke me to the possibility that directing a movie like that could be the best thing that ever happened. And to me, The Sea is my 2001. It's my, you know.
I guess so. That's a good way of looking at it. And the cinematography was so beautiful. The colors.
Thank you to John Conroy.
The palette of the colors were so muted changeable and fascinating. And, you know, each time I saw it twice, the beauty of, you know, like, for instance, Charlotte Rampling's costumes the second time around, I was going, oh, my God, I didn't get that the first time. You know, it's all this the subtlety.
Yeah, I think the landscape, the costume, the sense of place, it's what's between the lines in the movie.
Yes, yes.
That contributes to that emotional state.
Because, of course, the sea and the part of Ireland that is another character.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's not a glib thing. You know, it's not like we're trying to sort of impress everybody. It takes its place within the mind and the pain of the central character.
And it's just it's a joyous film, despite its kind of heavy.
Great, cool. You're good.
Well, I liked your movie. I like you.
I don't think it has to be depressing. Just because it's about it's something we all go through.
Well, if you enjoy filmmaking and the craft of it and great acting, that's the cathartic thing.
You.
Like, for instance, with 12 Years a Slave here, with the subject matter is just unbearable. But it's still an uplifting experience because it's been said finally. But as with The Sea, and I just hate to say goodbye to Steve, a fellow Stephen with a PH, Stephen Brown. Thank you so much for being here today on the Stephen Holt Show at the Toronto Film Festival. Yes, indeed. Here we are. Go Toronto. I got here. I had to do Kickstarter to get here, but I got here. Have a fabulous day.